Welcome to Let's Talk Movies with Caliwood Movies. In the house is TJ representing the whole damn world. Yeah! Got more energy right now. Welcome, TJ. How you doing?
Hey, Miss Sam. I'm doing okay. It's really great being on MSC TV talk show. And it's an honor for me because this movie thing is on a whole different level for me right now. A lot of people recognizing our talent has put my community on the map for shooting films. And we have not seen this anywhere else in Jamaica right now because we have series going out. We have other stuff coming up. So it's a lot for me.
And you're doing a fantastic job till you're in management right now for MSC TV Network, which I take very, very serious. So tell us a little bit about yourself. Tell us where you was born and tell us how you got started with MSC TV Network.
All right. So I was born in the parish of Manchester, Jamaica. I grew up with my mom, my dad, and the rest of my family and my real friends. You know, Chevy and Maestro, they were part of the production until
right.
the break. Been with MSC TV for over 3 years. The parish that I'm from, some of the greatest people in Jamaica come from that parish, unlike none other parish.
Right.
I'm residing in Kingston, which is Walton Park, great community, Campus Boulevard.
Right.
And I see myself even going further in the future, doing movies. Right now, it's a little bit slow because of the whole COVID-19 issues right now.
Right.
We have to be careful around. Even right now, I just pray for all my MSC TV brothers and sisters.
Everybody's safe,
right?
Yeah.
So
let's dive right into it. Your first big major movie that you done with MSC TV, which was one of our biggest movies because it was a collab with Florida Team and Kingston and Ocho Rios, the Black Mob Enterprise, which I was a part of too, playing a twin part. But you was on the gangster, real gangster side. Tell me a little bit about your character, how you felt when you was playing that, and how did it make you feel shooting with MSC TV Network?
Honestly, it let me feel very good to know that I worked so hard in the Black Mob Enterprise to see what we did coming out on top. A lot of people recognized us. I remember when it was going on and we had some scene to do on the streets, and there was a lot of people, a lot of eye and attention that made me feel like I was doing something great. And the feeling was just different from any other's feeling. And now, myself on a different level right now. And that movie, yesterday, it can't stop playing.
True.
Sometimes even my friend, Carl, still watching that movie. And it's really great for me. Honestly, it's been great.
The Black Mob Enterprise is still one of my favorite movies because, you know, we have about 25 movies out there. Even though it's one of the older ones, I could really relate to it. And I even enjoyed playing a twin part. So, but you've done very, very, very well. You guys got into character. All of you on that team, Diddy Don and Chevy, got into character and really made that shit happen for the Black Mob Enterprise. Yeah. Now, moving right along, another one of my favorite movie that you was in with Diddy Don and Chevy was Here Come Judas. Tell us a little bit about Here Come Judas.
That was a hit. That movie really was a hit for me because when I did that movie, honestly, I got feedback from a lot of people. Some big producers, some other people texted me when I sent them the link, and they were saying to me like, "No man, this that you doing is, you know, that this is really great. Don't, because you're not seeing certain extent to where this movie is going. But imagine if you were in the United States, or say United Kingdom, right now probably you would have been in Hollywood." Probably some person that I recognize it instantly and say, "No, I need him in a script. I need him in a movie." So that's the energy that I want to bring in other projects that we have coming up. even the orphanage that we have good.
I'll touch
People
on the
told me that.
orphanage in a minute, but I want to say, keep on doing what you're doing, TJ. Keep on doing what you're doing because eventually you will be in the United States because I plan, it's not right now because with the COVID and everything takes funds, but eventually I will be having some of my actors travel, whether it's to the United States, whether it's to Africa, whether it's to Germany. I'd like you to hook up with Germany and everybody intertwine and act with each other because we're global. We're a global performing arts.
Yeah,
So
definitely.
keep on doing
Definitely.
what you're doing because I'll be working on some visas, but you guys got to be patient with me. But I will invest in you, TJ, because you're worth investing in. So Here Come
Yeah.
Judas. Tell us a little bit about the storyline with Here Come Judas
All
without giving away too much.
right, so Here Comes Judas was a piece done by you yourself, Miss Sam, that we took part in, and it was filmed on the streets of Kingston, Jamaica, where a lot of youths don't have any home, and a lot of youths are turning to violence. But this movie brought out something different about violence, that it can be stopped. There's other means to it, and you have to be careful how you go out in the streets, how you trust your friends.
Exactly.
It is something different from anything else I have done. And this really mean a lot to me, honestly. And
Yeah.
sometimes I even watch it back. I feel so proud of myself because many person wouldn't even believe that a young like me would have been doing series and movie. Even when I've done it, people are saying, "Yo, Here Comes Judas, man, it's one of the craziest Jamaican film I've seen in a long time."
It's true.
Understand me? People
I
say, "Yo."
watch it. I watch it very regular. Now, moving on to the orphanage is a different level. It's a series. We have two series out on YouTube. People can go to MSE TV Network and subscribe so you can see TJ in some of these movies. Now, using Orphanage 2, and there's going to be an Orphanage 3.
Yeah, definitely.
Hopefully, when the COVID died down, we're going to do Orphanage 3. Now, that was dealing with the youth. So I take Orphanage, that series, very seriously because you really brought something unique to the Orphanage series movie. And do you want to explain a little bit about your character and the message that we're trying to convey to other people? With the
All
orphanage.
right.
Stop the
All
blinking,
right.
man.
So,
Stop the blinking. Yeah.
all right. Sorry about something just came on a while ago. So, the orphanage, honestly, that was one of the most epic project that I've worked on in a, honestly, it's a project that mean so much to me because seeing youngsters on the streets stealing, doing wrong stuff, when they watch this series, they can say, "Oh my gosh. Imagine if I should stop doing what I'm doing and, try to be something better." You know what I mean? So that level is just so different from other levels. You understand me?
So,
Because, you know,
so
go ahead,
explain,
go ahead.
sorry, I don't mean to talk over you. So explain your role as Mr. James in this, because
All
he's a character.
right. All right, so my role as Mr. James was to help the boys enroll in sports activities and try to be a better person in societies for the young man. And I helped them through certain problems, and in the end, they turn out to be something great. So that's why I'm telling you that every young youth have a future and have a destiny. It all depends on if you take your destiny seriously. That's what the orphanage taught me, and the youngsters, and
Right,
being the
because
best.
they look up to you as a role model, not only on the set of MSE TV Network Caliwoods, but also off the set. You still
Yeah.
take the time to go and actually visit these boys that are part of the youth team, for Caliwood movies, and you do sit down and you do mentor to these boys.
Yeah,
You
definitely.
know,
Yeah,
so
definitely.
we hold you in very great high esteem, TJ, that you're not only portraying this character on the set, you're also portraying this character off the set, which is very valuable to us, and we appreciate you and we love you for that. You really take
Yeah,
what you're doing seriously as an artist, as an actor, in the performing arts, and we're hoping by the end
mentor
of
them
next
and
year,
teach them to
or
act.
by next summer, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
So
honestly, yeah,
you're going to be leading in that, so rightly so, you know. So there's going to be a couple more movies that you'll be getting the lead. You're up for three Oscar awards within Caliwoods, rightly so, for the three movies that you've done. You have perfected it, especially with the orphanage. You just open up my eyes to a lot of things pertaining to the youth and things like that.
Definitely.
But I have to say something that I love about your acting. It really seems to come out natural. Like, it's not difficult for you to portray a certain character. And that's what I love about your energy that you bring to it. You just make it flow just naturally. You know, you're very convincing, you're very believable, and you're very articulate in delivering your lines and your script and everything. And you're just amazing, TJ. Amazing as an actor. That's why I wanted to interview you first, because I see something special in you. I really do. I always did. But the orphanage and Here Come Judas really deliver what type of actor you are to the world. You understand what I mean? So next year we're gonna have quite a few movies that you're gonna be in, play the leads. We still gotta do Daddy Girl 2, which I want you in. Mama Don't Cry as well. We're gonna have a couple of series, so I can't wait to see you even grow further, you know. I would really like to get Here Come Judas 2. I don't know, I might have to rewrite the script somehow, but I'm working on it. I am working on it, you know.
Yeah, man, that
But you
makes
are
sense. Makes a lot of
amazing. You are absolutely amazing.
I really do thank you for saying that we are amazing, because the level of generosity that you have put out in that movie, and other stuff. Honestly, it's countless. Honestly, it's countless.
Yeah,
Because
well, I love you guys. I love all my teams all around the world.
you
When do
can't pay
you
it back,
see?
honestly, because the motivation.
Right. Where
The
do you see
motivation.
yourself in the next 3 years with MSE TV, with your acting
All
career?
right. So I see myself in MSC TV in the next 2 years to 3 years as a management person, moving around from country to country, shooting videos. Maybe we could have some other leads in other movie series with other production. And MSC TV is the home of where it all started for me, and a lot of people is now seeing me, seeing my talent, feeling like a movie star in our family. That's how people feel about me. Because even this morning when I received the three Oscars nomination, my gosh, I show some people what I've been done with the work, with MSC TV, and they say, "Man, trust me. Anyway, continue doing this, boy." And I tell her, "Yeah,
You know, with
it's."
a nomination that comes with perks, but we will discuss that. We can't make everybody into your business. So we will talk offline by tomorrow what the perks come with the Oscars, and you got three. And I nominate you, but that also means that you're getting them. So it comes
It
with
makes a lot of
perks.
sense.
It comes with perks, and you've done a tremendous job. I must say, I'm glad that you stuck with me, you know, because you
I
know,
will
I've been
never give.
down my road ways already, you know, but you still flow and you're very open. You're very
Yeah.
honest and you're very loyal. Very
Honestly,
loyal.
it's been great for me, and honestly, I will never give up and I will never quit, and I really just want to grow more. I want to show my talent more to the world, because I know a little bit from now, people that I used to watch on TV, they will start watching me on TV now. So
Exactly.
that dream is a dream that it's a dream coming true. Honestly, it's a
Yeah,
dream
because
coming true.
eventually MSE TV network is gonna have their own network, you know, so don't worry about it. You'll be seen worldwide, and you've been seen worldwide by MSE TV network. So tell the people to subscribe on our YouTube. Go ahead.
Go ahead, and you could go ahead and check out Here Comes Judas. You could check out The Black Mob, and you could check out the Orphanage series. Okay, MSC TV production. Just remember that.
Yeah, MSE TV Network on YouTube. Everybody go over there now and watch TJ do his thing as an actor. Well, it was great. Huh?
Yes, ma'am. It's been great. Honestly, it's been great. It's been great.
It's been great. I'm glad that you took the opportunity to allow us to interview you and talk about your music and your concepts in the acting game right now. And a lot of more people, funnily, I'm noticing, is getting into acting now because it's a way of expressing oneself. It's a way of getting over a message across to the people that is needed at such a time like this. We will be talking to you and we'll be seeing you in the Orphanage 3. I can't wait for that because the team has
Gosh.
written the script and it bend up, it twists up, alter shift. It's going to be hotter than one
Listen,
and very,
I
very,
can't
very
wait to see
proud of
you
you. I have a
in
lot of
that.
love and respect for you, TJ. A
A lot
lot.
for you, same way. A lot
For
for you,
real.
same way.
For real. All
Yeah.
right. Take care.
Done, man.
Yeah,
Yeah, deal with.
yeah, the outside,
Look,
you dog,
yeah,
yeah,
so the dog just a come out
yeah,
of the
dog, just
pen.
a jump out, dog, you
Buck
know, like,
now,
that
yes,
about
eh?
them, look, not save me
Jam
out,
room,
dog,
madam.
yeah, that, them thing they are
Yeah, so
going,
you know what I go, I'm a friend, dog,
so
you
you
know
up
me,
to the
but,
friendly door, madam.
them they are going, he's back with mumsy and sis, you see me?
Yes, yeah, there, Buck still a go and do the dirt, though.
Yeah,
So,
they are going.
Peter, deal with.
So Peter go over there, yeah, I think he says, street I go, hot, dog,
Yeah, man, I
you
mean,
see
yeah,
me?
see, you come back to
Yeah,
come
dog.
run the ground, you know?
Like, I don't know my ground here, there, so we come take it over. You know, go already.
All
Our one
right,
team, brother. Our ground.
all
You
right,
see?
madam. You don't
You
have to
know
say
what go.
40, man.
You
You
want to say
don't say
40, man. You
39.
see?
I hear that.
I'm team G, man.
All right, there, you know, I'm there.
Let us run the kitchen and put door.
Oh, bless me, come for bless you, you know. But you may say, do you know? Yo, Judas, there, you know. Yo, make sure you don't say nothing to Judas, you know.
No worry about that, man. I'm buying that old little thing that. No worry about that, man.
Alright, watch this now, I can't bother with the problem, you know. The same say, yo, we baby before I do a you know.
I done tell him that already.
Alright.
But if I say I'm going to pressure somebody to check him out and tell him to not worry about it either.
Oh, so that him I say?
Yeah.
You just
Yeah.
stick to your
Must
stick.
say
Go on.
brother.
The money not come through, dog. I don't even know how the fuck that, brother.
Money not come through, Dan.
Yeah, I could declare or something, you know.
No way, they know, Dan.
Dog,
Yeah,
beg
bro,
your
got
fuck,
it.
dog.
Go on,
I
do it,
need
man.
the money.
Come back
Man,
that
need
deal.
the money in there, brother.
That's
Go
the
on,
thing,
do
say,
it, man.
me,
dog.
got man.
Vex your fuck, dog.
I look some
Yo,
weed on
I
some
look
rum,
some
man.
Weed, dog. I'm a
Say
fresh out,
up,
dog. I need to take that switch out of my brain, brother. You see me?